Hi, I'm Kylie from Privyr, and today I'm going to show you how to generate leads using Privyr Lead Forms. Privyr Lead Forms are a quick, free, and easy way to generate more leads without the complex setup. It takes less than a minute to create your custom form and start collecting leads. These forms are already built into Privyr, so if you have a Privyr account, you have Privyr Lead Forms. If you don't have a Privyr account, you can create one right now. It takes less than 30 seconds. Just go to privyr.com or use the link in our description to create your free account. It is super easy. You may have seen our video about how to use Privyr Lead Forms, which shows you the basics about how these forms work. If you haven't seen that video yet, we've put the link in the description for you. This video talks about what to do with your Privyr Lead Form after you've created it, so that you can collect the most leads. We'll show you the best places to share your Privyr Lead Form so that you can collect leads online or offline without having to pay for ads. We're also gonna run through ways to design your lead form to further encourage leads to submit their details so you can get the maximum number of leads. Let's get started. So you probably already know that Privyr Lead Forms come with two ways to share them: a link which you can share on social media, your website, over WhatsApp, text, email, and many more places, and a QR code. But where should you share them so that it's not just you throwing links out into the void? So since you have your lead in QR code, the easiest thing for you to do is to display that link and that QR code in places you're already using to generate traffic or promote your business. This includes your website, your social media profiles, including your link tree or any other links you use in your bio, and online forums or other spaces where your target audience hangs out. This can be Reddit, Facebook groups, WhatsApp groups. These are places where you're likely already hosting content to promote your products and services. So when you post your link or your QR code there, you'll be able to attract your followers and other curious visitors. You can also run ads on the link to your Privyr lead form. While lead sources like Facebook lead ads and Google Forms also collect your leads details, remember that the moment your lead submits details to your Privyr lead form, their contact and details appear inside your Privyr app. So there's no need to spend time coming through a CSV or setting up an integration. Privyr already handles that for you. And from the Privyr app, you can reach out to that lead instantly in just a few taps. The other thing I want to talk about is leveraging your QR code for physical and digital marketing materials. This includes flyers that you're handing out or mailing out, event banners and posters in places with high foot traffic. This can include your physical shop if you have one, standees and tabletop displays, slides that you present during webinars, seminars, trainings, and more. And you can even keep the QR code saved as a screenshot on your phone. And this way, when you're at a trade show or an event like a client open house, or even just talking about your business at a networking event, you're always ready to capture a lead quickly and easily when they're engaged with you and expressing interest in your product or service. So make sure you're using as many of these sharing channels as you can to get your Privyr lead form out there and to attract as many interested leads as possible. So we've talked about where to share your Privyr lead form, but how do you encourage leads when they access that form to go through and leave their details? So the first thing you need to remember is they probably reached your lead form through your website, an event, seeing it on your poster, or even through an interesting conversation with you. So this lead is already interested in what you have to offer. You just have to encourage them the rest of the way. Privyr Lead Forms offers several opportunities to move your lead towards completing the form, so let's go through them together. But first, we have the title, the description, and the display picture. Make sure your lead form clearly communicates what your lead will get by submitting their interest here, and that way they're motivated to enter their details. That can mean that they know if they fill this in, you're gonna send them a brochure or guide, or you'll share more information, give them a consultation, or start a conversation, booking an appointment, any of those things. So you're gonna wanna give your form a simple descriptive title, like interest form. Download the guide / brochure, get in touch with, and then put your name or company here, or learn more about, and then fill in your service. Then you use the description field to talk about what you want from your lead and what they're going to get in return. So you can see that here are some examples. You can write in, view the latest e-brochure guide now. We'd love to help you with your education goals. Fill in your contact information and your personal consultant will be in touch with you. You can see some other examples here. Under form fields, try to use the least number of fields as possible. That means that if you only need name and phone number, then you don't need to show the email and comments fields. The faster your lead can complete your form, the more likely they are to finish it instead of abandoning it in the middle of typing in all those details. Just collect the information that matters. And finally, make sure you use a nice header image for your form. Like, look at these forms side by side. One has a header image and the other one doesn't. In the same way that using a display picture or profile picture on Facebook or Instagram makes your profile look more engaging, more legit, and raises engagement, a picture makes your lead form look so much more inviting and also trustworthy to a prospect. And then the last thing I want to talk about here is the success message. The success message shows up after your lead has submitted their details. Make this part warm and appreciative. Make your lead feel good for writing in their information. Express gratitude, but also make sure they know what to expect next. So you can just add in a line like we have here about how someone will contact them soon via phone call or WhatsApp with more information. And that way your lead is expecting that message or call, even if it comes from an unknown contact. So there you have it. Now you know how to share a Privyr lead form and how to design the form to encourage your prospects to submit their details. Now make sure to try this out using the Privyr app. Share it around and comment here to us about how it's working. We love to hear from you. We have a link to create a Privyr account in the comment section. From there, you can download the app and start using Privyr lead forms immediately. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We have so much other content to share about Privyr, its features, and sales tips and tricks that can help you turn your leads into clients. Thanks for watching and take care. I'm Kylie from Privyr, and I will see you soon.